Hello, and welcome to this Warhammer Age of Sigmar painting video for a Stormcast Eternal Night Questor. This will be the first Stormcast figure that I have painted. Now, originally, I was thinking of painting my models as hammers of Sigmar, because I own all the Warhammer Quest Age of Sigmar boxed sets, which meant that I accumulated quite a lot of Stormcast heroes, and thought they looked rather good in gold. Also, the Hammers of Sigmar colour scheme is quite an easy one to paint. Whilst the models do look good in Warhammer Quest, I've realised that the Hammers of Sigmar is a very common colour scheme for Stormcast Eternals. I'd like something a little different. Also, when you see a large Hammers of Sigmar army, I think the overwhelming gold can be very overpowering. So, I recently bought the Stormcast Eternals Battletome, and there are a variety of special rules for different chambers of Stormcast from various different strikings. With different colour schemes. Different rules. The Hammers of Sigmar are a fairly solid set of rules that can help you if you've got a lot of liberators in your army. But I quite like the Hallowed Knights. My second Age of Sigmar army is Disciples of Zinch army, and I'd like to use the two armies against each other with a friend. One of the Hallowed Knight's special abilities is to disregard the effects of enemy spells, and Disciples of Zinch use a lot of spells. The other benefit of the Hallowed Knights is their chambers must contain a Lords of the Storm battalion, which must contain at least 6 heroes. And since I've got all of the Warhammer Quest box sets, and a couple of other Stormcast heroes, I'm able to fulfil the requirements of this battalion, which will also give me benefits for my heroes. The one thing I dislike about the Hallowed Knights is the colour scheme, strangely. Since I've said, I feel a little off-putted about the overwhelming amount of gold on a Hammer of Sigmar Stormcast. In the artwork, I think the Hallowed Knights look quite nice. Here's a Lord Castellant of the Hallowed Knights. But the... And here's some more Hallowed Knights, I think. But the actual metallic painting of a Hallowed Knight army is based on silver rather than gold. and I'm a little tired of greyish metallic feel that predominantly silver armies have. This is a Hallowed Knight army. I didn't want to have to be shading my knights blue, or with a bluish tinge, like Grey Knights in Warhammer 40,000. So, I'm going to be experimenting with a white-gold colour scheme of silver highlighted up from a gold base coat, which I've not seen done. So it may not work, but nothing ventured, nothing gained. Basically, I'm going to be using an old Citadel tank brush to do a very heavy dry brush of my Knight Questor with a very bright Stormhost silver paint. And then I think I'll attempt an edge highlight. Although I am very poor at those. With an even brighter silvery paint. Let's see if that's enough. You can always add more later. Okay, there's still quite a lot of paint on that brush, which is about what I'm after. Let's give it a go. I think I'll cover everything at this stage and then just go back later and paint the bits that I don't want white gold. Obviously, most of the cloak isn't going to have any gold on it. Maybe just a little bit there. And since this is a complete experiment, it may not work out. The Questor is perhaps one of the better models to try it on. Since I think Questors are sent out by Sigmar. To fight alone in the mortal realms. Certainly I think the first time they appeared was in the Silver Tower Warhammer Quest game. And a quest Questor works alone in that. Or rather, with some unusual companions. For a Stormcast of Sigmar, at least. This brush is so large that I am struggling to reach in all the crevices. I may go back with a smaller dry brush in a moment. Although I do like to keep my paints and brushes separate, with specific brushes for metallic paints. And I don't think I've set aside a small metallic dry brush yet. There are a lot of ASMR brushing videos, brushing the mic, brushing the face. ASMR is a relaxation phenomena. For those of you who are watching this video, since you're primarily Age of Sigmar or Warhammer fans, rather than ASMR fans, and you can find more about it on YouTube and Google. ASMR is the reason why I'm speaking quietly and slowly. Okay. I don't think that looks gold anymore. We are having trouble focusing, aren't we? There. That's kind of the white gold effect I wanted. Now a dry brush shouldn't take too long to dry because it's dry already. There are a number of different ways of playing games of Warhammer Age of Sigmar. And I think initially I'll go for the narrative format. With an eye to keeping the matched play value of my Stormcast and Disciples of Zinch armies roughly equal. But since I'd be using the narrative play options, I won't have to work out the points values, and I won't have to abide by the army requirements. So I'll be able to use all of the models that I have for my heroes in the Lords of the Storm battalion, even though I may not have as many points as would be required to field the battalion in a matched play format. I have a Lord Celestant on Drakoth from the Age of Sigmar box set. I have a Lord Relictor from the same box set. I have a large Griffhound from Shadows over Hammerhal. I have a Lord Castellant from Shadows over Hammerhal. I have a Knight Venator from the Mighty Heroes set, and a Knight Heraldor from the Arcane Heroes set, as well as the second Knight Heraldor. The rules for the Lords of the Storm allow me to improve the bravery of Stormcast Eternals that are near heroes in this battalion, which is similar to a rule for the Hammers of Sigmar, which increases their bravery by one. And the Wave of Celestial Might rule allows battering of celestial energy inflict mortal wounds on enemy units within close range of groups of three or more heroes from this battalion. The other battalions that the Hallowed Knights have access to are the Thunderhead Brotherhood and Hammerstrike Force, which are fairly standard warrior battalions of Liberators and Judicators, Paladins and Prosecutors. So, with the addition of a few units to a start collecting box and the Age of Sigmar boxed game, I should be able to add to the Hallowed Knights with a couple more of those battalions. The Edge Highlight Painter will be using, which hopefully will show up against Stormhouse Silver, is Metal Medium. By Vallejo. Okay. I think perhaps I was a little too vigorous with the Storm Host Silver eye brush. Or perhaps it's just so pale. The Villager medium isn't showing up very well against it. There's certainly not a great deal of contrast between the Storm Host and the Villager paint. Really isn't focusing on this distraction in the background, is it? See if that helps. Try an edge highlight on the sword to see if that shows up. Another idea to add a bit more texture to the model. It's a radical idea. Considering using verdigris as a shade. Will radically alter the look of a model, since the standard colour for a Stormcast Eternal is a very clean metallic. Verdigris is a paint, and in effect, both in nature and in painting, it's usually only applied. Corroded metals. I'm really not sure if this is showing up against the dry brush or not. On the palette, the Stormcast paint does look a lot darker than the Hallowed paint. Certainly it doesn't have the burnished gold effect that Hammers of Sigmar Stormcast have. Ah, now we're getting a bit of contrast there, you can see. Perhaps because I didn't apply quite as much on the back. was a very quick first attempt at painting my Stormcast. Or at least the silver armor pieces. Focus, man. That's about as good as we're going to get. I hope you'll join me for the next video in this series, when we start applying some colour to the model. And probably some burnished gold areas as well. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.